प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू गौरी ट्यूटोरियल्स यूट्यूब चैनल एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन सो दैट यू कुड गेट द नोटिफिकेशन ऑफ न्यू वीडियोस एज द टाइम ऑफ अपलोड.
Today we are going to start with the chapter 16, that is digestion and absorption. In this part of the chapter, we are going to study about the concept of nutrition and nutrients. Now, first of all, we are going to study what is nutrition. Now, nutrition is the process of obtaining all the substances which are necessary for the growth and maintenance of the body. Nutrition is that process which helps us to take up all the substances which are necessary for the growth of the body, like proteins, because they provide building material and maintenance of the body. And for maintenance of the body, we need to take proteins, vitamins, minerals, and also carbohydrates and fats, which give us energy to do various kind of works. So this all process of taking up the food and utilizing it in the process of growth and maintenance is called as nutrition. Now, the chemical substances which are present in the food to sustain the life, they are called as nutrients. These nutrients, they provide our body with energy. Like we know that fats and carbohydrates, they are the energy giving food. These nutrients, they provide us energy to do work, and some of the nutrients like that of the proteins, they provide us the building material to grow and repair in case there is any problem. Now, regarding the type of nutrients, they are of majority, they are of two types. We can categorize them into two major types. One are the macronutrients. Macro means more, which are required in more amount. So these nutrients are taken in more amount, like that of carbohydrates, lipids or fats and proteins. They are taken up by the body in more amount. So they are called as macronutrients. On the other side, there are certain nutrients which are required in less amount by the body, because they just help in carrying out the different reactions which are taking place in the body. For example, there are minerals, there are vitamins. These are not required in much amount. They are required in little amount in the body. Then next is the type of nutrients. Now there are, types of nutrition. Now there are two major types of nutrition. One is autotrophic mode of nutrition. Second is heterotrophic mode of nutrition. As the name suggests, autotrophic means organisms are able to make their own food. While in heterotrophic mode of nutrition, organisms, they take up their food from other organisms. They cannot prepare their own food. Now, autotrophic mode is again carried out by two different processes. One is photosynthesis and second is chemosynthesis. As the name suggests, photo means light, and synthesis means production. So photosynthesis is done in the presence of light. These are performed by the green plants and some bacteria which have the required pigments for that. And on the other side, chemo means chemical energy. These here the chemical energy of the reactions that is utilized for the production of the food. So chemical synthesis. These are conducted by sulfur bacteria. There are certain nitrifying bacteria like nitrosomonas and some iron bacteria. They also undergo this process. They are called as chemoautotrophs, while those carrying photosynthesis are called as photoautotrophs. Now, regarding the heterotrophic mode of nutrition, these organisms, they cannot prepare their own food. They have to be dependent on other organisms to take food. Now, what kind of food they take up, on the basis of that, they are categorized into different types. Like first is holozoic mode of nutrition. In this mode of nutrition, the organisms, they feed on the solid organic food materials. These include different categories. Like first are herbivores. They eat up plants, as we know about deer, cow, etc. These organisms, they take up the plant as their food matter. as a plant matter as their food. And second are the carnivores. These organisms, they feed on the animals. For example, lion, tiger, wolf, etc. And omnivores. Omnivores are those organisms which take up both plant matter as well as animal matter. Then are the cannibals. Cannibals are the organisms which feed the members of their own species. There are certain snakes, cockroaches and some fishes. They eat up the members of their own species. Like snakes, they eat up the other snakes of the same species. So such kind of mode of taking food is called cannibalism. And these organisms are called as cannibals. Then next mode is detritivores. Detritivores, they feed upon the dead organic matter present in the mud. For example, earthworms, they take up the dead organic matter which is present in the soil. Then there are scavengers. Scavengers are the organisms, they are also called as carrion eaters because they feed on the dead bodies of the organisms. For example, vultures, hyena, etc., they are the scavengers. Then last type among the holozoic moda, coprophagus. Copro word is for the fecal matter. So phagus means eating. They feed on the feces of other organisms like dung beetles. There are pigs and in some cases rabbits also. Sometimes they feed on the waste matter of the organism. So these are called as coprophagus. These were the different types of holozoic mode of nutrition. Now there are saprophytic also. Saprophytic organisms, they include bacteria, fungi, etc. They feed on the dead matter. They secrete the enzymes, digest that dead matter and absorb it from the surface of their body. For example, there are many kind of bacteria which have this kind of mode of nutrition. Yeast, among fungi, mushrooms, molds, these are all example of saprophytic mode of nutrition. Then is osmotrophic mode of nutrition. Now this mode of nutrition, animals, they take up the pre-digested food material by diffusion through their body walls. For example, endoparasites like Tinea solium, it is a flatworm. It absorbs the digested food in the intestine through its body surface. This kind of mode of nutrition is called osmotrophic. And last of all is parasitic mode. You must have studied about this also. Parasites are those organisms which take up their food matter from the other living organisms. The other living organisms on which they live or inside their body which they live are called as host. And these organisms which take their food from host while the host is living, they are called as parasites. So these are the different modes of nutrition in different organisms. Now the different steps of holozoic mode of nutrition. Now in holozoic mode of nutrition, first step is ingestion or taking in of the food. That is taken place with the help of mouth. And after the taking in of the food, it is broken down. This process is called as digestion. It takes place in the different parts of alimentary canal, which we'll be studying in next video. Then are the absorption of food. After the digestion, the small particles of the food, which are the digested products, have to be absorbed by the intestine into the blood of the organism. Only then it is considered that the food is inside the body, that is physiologically inside the body, and is able to be utilized by the organism. The next part is assimilation. Assimilation is that part where the absorbed products are to be used by the body cells for actually forming the proteins or meeting the daily requirements. Then last step is egestion. It takes place by the removal of the waste or the undigested food as well as the food which is unabsorbed from the intestine. That part of the food is removed by this process. This is called as egestion. So these are the different steps of holozoic mode of nutrition. Now in the next part of the video, we'll be studying about the process of digestion.